We're going to teach how to don and doff half-mask respirator. The first thing that you want to do is make sure you check the respirator to make sure that the straps are in good condition. They're pliable. When they stretch out, they bounce back. You want to take a look at the exhaust valve to make sure it's in place. And it's at the bottom of the respirator, and it's in place, soft, pliable, and it's laying flat. Snap the cover back on so it doesn't get damaged. You want to take a look at the inside. You want to make sure you look at the diaphragms that are on both sides to make sure that they're soft and pliable and laying flat, not crumpled like this. Also important after washing it to make sure that they're laying flat so they don't dry crispy or in the wrong place. And so check diaphragms on both sides and that the straps are in order. And then you're ready to use the respirator. The other thing is to make sure that the filters are appropriate for what you want to use them for. This is a P100 filter, which is good for H1N1, also dust and other particles, but it will not be appropriate for use with chemicals and vapors because it will allow those to pass right through. If you need to get cartridges for those types of elements or hazards, make sure you consult with the safety officer or your supervisor. An important thing to remember with the respirators, before you use a respirator, you have to be fit test with the respirator. And as a part of that fit test, a part of the respirator itself, you should not have any facial hair that should interfere with the face seal or where the respirator fits around your face. Important to make sure that you should be clean shaven in those areas. Even a day's worth of stubble or a day's worth of growth can cause fit interference. So those are very important things. The other thing too, you will want to make sure that you get checked if you have changes in facial features, fit test again, changes in facial features like weight loss, dental work that may impact the fit. So those are some important things to remember before you use a respirator. So what you first do is you set it up against your chin, then you pull the top strap over, tighten the top strap, then hook the neck strap, and then go ahead and tighten those straps. And I will go ahead and demonstrate that now. You need to remove your glasses before you put them on, before you put a respirator on. You set it up against the chin, pull the top strap over while you're holding it in place, take the neck straps, hook them in back of the neck. Then you grab the straps and pull them if need be. And mine are fine, so I don't necessarily need to do that, but you pull these straps accordingly. And then these straps right here, you would pull that and tighten that. And if not, you could take it off to readjust it. And then we want to do the fit check. And I'm going to do the negative fit check first by covering the filter cartridges and slightly inhale. Then I will do the positive fit check by covering the exhaust valve, which is down here, and then slightly exhale. We're checking for leakage around the face seal. If you feel any leakage, you want to take the mask off, tighten the straps, and apply it again. To remove the respirator, you want to make sure you're not touching the filter cartridges. You can unhook the neck strap like so. Hold on to it like such, not touching the cartridges. Lift it up and off your face like such.